Ta-dum.
That's what's going on right now. It took John and I a while to figure out what's happening. Guys, we got ourselves another teaser trailer for Stranger Things 4, and it's not just 10 seconds. It's like a minute and 20 or something like that. Creel House. That's the character who's playing?
Oh.
Do you not know?
Who's playing Creel?
Come on, John, you're the know-it-all guy at the channel.
Oh, damn.
I'll give you a hint.
Is it an 80s
actor?
I'll
give you a hint.
Okay.
It's Robert Englund.
All right. Fredward showing up.
All right.
Excited.
Let's see what's going on today. I have this hat, which implies I'm the biggest Stranger Things fan in the world.
It's your Dustin hat.
It's when you wear a piece, article of clothing representing the IP you're covering, that means automatically, wow, they must be a mega fan.
Yeah. I'm Dacre Montgomery from season 2 now.
Oh, great. Now you just overshadow this whole video with sex appeal.
Sorry. I'm gonna put this up.
Something sinister is coming.
Stranger Conjurings.
Creepy doll.
Oh. It's a nice blouse, though.
I actually believe that accent.
I did too.
Take it back. That kind of, in every trailer.
Oh, yeah.
Interesting. So it seems like there's an investigative mystery at a obviously.
Something about this freaky.
You know, if I were to use my intellect and examination skills, I would presume with my deep diving that there's a mystery happening at a house this time, and they need to go investigate what's going on.
I picked up a clue when they said they were looking for clues.
Yeah, well, the first half of the trailer focused on this one man's house. Yeah, so from my understanding, I saw like a snippet of something yesterday, but I was like, okay, maybe we're going to see like an expansion of this in the trailer today, which it didn't. All these teaser trailers have been so ominous and mysterious, you know, Stranger Things fashion. They were saying has like this Victor Creel character is this like takes place in the 50s with his character, and then he was like accused of murdering his family.
It's like
stuff.
Amityville.
Yeah, pretty much. But as this trailer establishes, it's wasn't him.
The Upside Down did it.
Damn that Upside Down. Turning people's lives upside down. It's metaphorical. Yeah, I mean, that's an interesting take. I know in like the first season when Joyce is looking for Will.
Will.
I know when Joyce is looking for Will, that's taking place in a house essentially, but they didn't do something like this that it's riffing on something that feels like haunted house.
Yeah, exactly. It feels like they're taking a direct sort of haunted house horror movie vibe for this season. It almost reminded me of a less pulpy American Horror Story trailer in certain ways. Just that whole like, oh, we got, you know, the past and the echoes of whatever happened here, and then we got the kids meddling. There'll be monsters involved, but I'm sure also something to do with this family will be involved. Yeah, like it seems like a sensible route for them to take Stranger Things because there's always been horror inside of it, and yet somehow just looking at this, I'm like, they really do seem to be plugging in and dialing up the haunted house chiller vibe.
True.
You know?
I mean, and of course, one of the best parts about this trailer, Stephen Dustin.
That's right, always.
Those two together is some of the magic of Stranger Things. Mm-hmm. I'm a much bigger Joe Carey fan. Not a big Joe Carey fan, but Joe Carey. Remember Joe when Carey. He ran for president?
That's right, man. Everybody was so bummed when he lost.
Joe Carey. Especially after Free Guy in that one movie where he played a creep. Mm-hmm. What was that movie? He's in a phenomenal actor. And then Lucas's new hair. That's got to be the talk of the season,
dude,
right?
Flat top Lucas, man. Finally, people will remember that Lucas is here. Yeah. I feel like people always need reminding of Lucas as a character.
I loved his hair. But yeah, it's like every trailer has focused on like the tick of the clock, zoom ins on the clock. Mm. Usually that is like a suspenseful countdown to something like that or ramping up anxiety. But it's Stranger Things, you know, so you read way too much into things. However, the trailers do put a lot of emphasis on it. And I believe you brought this up to me, that like the popular theory is that it's gonna deal with time travel. And based off the fact that you see the first half of this trailer focusing on Creel, 1950s house, they go to his house, they're focusing on the clock there, maybe there will be something of like transporting them back into the past, because clearly it wasn't him who did it. I am wondering too, after like the events of Stranger Things 1 with Will, and then, you know, we all know about the lights and everything like that. What was the guy, Dacre Montgomery, what's his character's name?
Dacre Montgomery. I remember Max, and somehow I can't remember what his name
was. What was his name? He had such a heartbreaking
sexy lifeguard, I know.
The way how they controlled him.
Yeah, and Billy?
Billy, there you go. Yeah, Red Ranger.
Yeah,
Blue Ranger. He's a Red Ranger. No, that's Jason.
Billy's Blue Ranger, but he played the Red Ranger, which is Jason.
Billy, how he was controlled and became like a total psychopath.
Yeah, a vessel for the Upside Down.
So I'm wondering if that's kind of a similar thing that happened with the Creel guy.
Could be.
Or if it just straight up was framing for murder.
It just broke through and was like, perfect opportunity.
I hate this guy. I'm going to frame him.
Yeah, well, and the other thing too is, think about it, we got a flashback to what looks like the 50s. We take place in like the 80s roughly. It's the perfect time periods to do some time travel back to the future, riffing Stranger Things season 4. Maybe they'll get sucked into the middle of the clock, or maybe Eleven's trying to punch through and it turns out she's in the clock. Maybe the Upside Down just exists in that clock.
So somehow we're gonna focus here, and we're also gonna focus on connecting this to whatever's going on with Hopper in Russia.
Yes, exactly.
But maybe this, or maybe this is like some type of, you know, transporting vessel of sorts.
Maybe this will just be a great way to for them to easily get to Russia in like a second.
Or it's just a clock.
It's just a clock. It's just a clock.
Never forget
and
that.
And then there'll be a subplot where we cut away to Joyce and Will and all them just living life. Yeah. just having a life away from Hawkins and doing regular people's stuff.
What did you guys think about the trailer? Leave your thoughts down below. What are your craziest Stranger Things theories? Subscribe, click that bell, hit that like button. Hey, we'll catch you guys soon.